Kurt?
Hey.
Good morning. I'm Kurt Nunnally, past commander and adjutant of American Legion Glenford Dugan Post 229 here in Nelsonville. Memorial Day 2024, we gather again to honor all American veterans who gave their lives in sacrifice to our nation. We will begin today's ceremony with the playing of the national anthem by the Nelsonville York Band. Thank you. Chaplain Shoemaker of Post 229 will now offer the invocation.
Let us pray. Almighty God, giver of all victories, we thank thee for the opportunities which abide in our land, for the guidance in the hour of peril and thy tender love in times of need. Help us remember with reverence and valor devotion of our departed comrades, not only those whose bodies consecrate our country's soil, but also those who sleep beyond the seas and others whose resting places will not be known until the last day when the deep will be giving up its dead. O God, teach us to honor them by ever cherishing the ideals for which they have fought. Keep us steadfast in the cause of human rights and liberties, of law and order and true Americanism. Give us the power to see and will to do right. Grant the American people may preserve the high ideals for which our comrades died. May thy merciful blessing rest upon those they left behind. Keep us forever firm in righteousness, humble of heart, and unselfish in purpose. Amen.
American Legion and VFW will now place wreaths at the flagpole. Commander of the Honor Guard, Salute the dead. Honor Guard, you are now dismissed to go to the other cemeteries. The NY Band will now play another song. Thank you to the band. Our speaker today is Tanya Stone. She is a retired Lieutenant Colonel from the United States Air Force. She spent 25 years in service to the nation as an airfield operations officer at various statewide and European duty locations. Her missions included support to the Global War on Terrorism and the NATO mission to aid in the defense of Ukraine. In her civilian capacity, she is a senior director for development in the Rust College of Engineering and Technology at Ohio University. She lives with her husband, two sons, and three German shepherds at her family's Meadowview farm outside Nelsonville. Tanya Stone.
Good morning, friends and neighbors. Welcome on this 2024 Memorial Day to Greenlawn Cemetery, this place of rest so beautifully maintained by our York Township public servants. Thank you, Kurt, for the kind introduction and for inviting me to speak this morning. And thank you, citizens, for taking a few moments to listen while we remember those who fought and died protecting our freedoms. Memorial Day was originally called Decoration Day, first proclaimed by General George Logan of the Grand Army of the Republic in 1868 as a way to honor those fallen in service to our country. We gather here at Greenlawn year after year in moments of silence and reverence to add some meaning to our three-day weekend. And for that, I commend you. But who is it really that we honor? And how should we truly honor them? These ceremonies are important, but even more important is our actions as we go about our lives. My husband's great-grandfather moved here as a storekeep in the late 1800s to service the coal miners in our area. And while I somehow managed to have a 25-year career in the U.S. Air Force without ever having picked up the game of golf, I could hit a golf ball from where I'm standing now to the location of his Doaneville store just across Monday Creek. Those miners and merchants built this place we call our home. Over the years, many went off to war, serving a greater cause on the battlefield, and many of those are buried here in various plots around Greenlawn. Those who gave the last full measure of devotion in a great cause did so in order for their comrades to return home for an equally great cause here, to work hard, to raise their families, to build their businesses and local infrastructure, and seek to improve the lives of their countrymen and build this great American democracy. I am a retired Lieutenant Colonel who served on both active duty and in the Air Force Reserves. And during my 25 years, I served two tours overseas. I cherished my time abroad interacting with people very different from me. But these experiences also helped me fully appreciate the special thing we have here in this country and to not take it for granted. However, to keep this nation, to keep this place we all love and call home, it requires work. Work that we owe to those who perished in defense of this nation. We must educate ourselves about the problems and challenges we face and understand the potential solutions. There is no shortage of information, but true understanding is not easy. The internet is an amazing tool. Cable TV provides hundreds of channels. Social media is full of content. But if we're not careful, all they do is provide an echo chamber where all of our news and information comes from people we agree with and who present exactly what we want to hear. They yell their oversimplified 20-second opinions at us from the box in our living room or our car radio or the little computers in our pockets, and we accept it without question. In this mass of information coming at us from all directions, we yearn for a simplicity that is no longer there. Media outlets, politicians, and advertisers know this, and they blitz us with 10-second sound bites or the quick splash of a headline in our Facebook feed. Is our attention lost when we encounter something longer and more complex? Can we even focus on it? How many of you have checked your smartphone 3 times since I started talking? Maybe you got a notification from your favorite Facebook group, or Taylor Swift put up a new Instagram post, or you got an urgent text from someone trying to raise money for Trump or Biden. But the things that matter, the things that truly matter to the health of our democracy, are complex and nuanced, and they require us to truly focus. Tax policy. No one likes paying taxes, but we do like the things they pay for, like this well-kept cemetery, for instance. School funding formulas, broadband communications infrastructure, energy policy, environmental conservation, healthcare reform, None of this is simple, and we can't understand it or effectively contribute to the discussion if we only catch the short sound bites someone tells us on social media. Or maybe national defense strategy and whether a particular case for war was strong enough to send our sons and daughters to kill or to be killed on behalf of the United States of America. This is hard, complicated stuff that we don't want to think about. Not only am I a retired Air Force veteran, but I am also an Army wife. Many of you know my husband is a soldier. In less than two months, my firstborn son, a recent Nelsonville York High School graduate, will ship to U.S. Navy indoctrination. And at the age of 15 and a half, my younger son is already considering his military plans. So American defense policy hits very close to home in my family. But less than 1% of Americans are in uniform today. And it is so easy for the other 99% to not pay attention. We have a responsibility as citizens of the greatest nation in history to engage and understand the world, read the newspaper, listen to radio news, read periodicals and nonfiction to educate yourself about complex topics. Browse the internet, but do it with an open mind. Not only searching for opinions you are comfortable hearing, but instead look for the detailed concepts so you can make informed decisions at your workplace, at the store, and at the ballot box. Push the bounds of your comfort zone. Talk with people not like you. Perhaps a different race or religion or national origin or political persuasion. Note, I didn't say talk at them. Listen to them. Put yourself in their shoes. Try to understand how they see the world. They are not the enemy. They are fellow Americans who care just as much as you do about this great nation we call home, but may just see things differently. Doing all of these things will make us more productive, integrated citizens of the United States. Honoring our military dead is the sacred duty of every American. While inspiring speeches and beautiful songs and flags on graves and 21-gun salutes and moments of silence are all fitting and appropriate, but those things are not remotely enough to recognize their sacrifice. We owe them much, much more. We must be informed, thoughtful friends and neighbors who work hard and help one another for the common good. If we can do this, if all of us can do this, we will keep and maintain this nation as the greatest on earth, this place for which they gave their lives. Thank you.
The chaplain will now offer the benediction, and then I will have some closing remarks.
May our Lord bless us all present here to memorialize those who lived and died to preserve liberty and freedom in our nation and in the world. And may the Lord our God remember all those whose sacrifice gave this nation in greatness, progress, and riches. May our memory of all those who served in the armed forces be honorable ones, full of thanksgiving to the Lord, and remember with much love and mercy whose though died in the service of our country, whether on the air, on the land, or in the sea. Be with us all and provide us with traveling mercy as we return to our own. Amen.
Thank you to all those that replaced the flags here in the cemetery and the area cemeteries. these flags, if you will notice, these are just but a sprinkling of the flags around this area, the state, nation, and overseas. There are 24 American cemeteries and memorials overseas. Thousands of war dead buried at these sites. So as we depart, remember the reason for this day. Have an honorable, meaningful, and respectful Memorial Day. Thank you for attending.
Good morning, everybody. How y'all doing out there today? We had a great day, but boy, yesterday I wasn't counting on it. I was thinking, holy cow, it's going to get rained out. We'd like to welcome everybody to the annual Veteran Day celebration. We'd like to honor all the men and women that gave their lives so that we would have the freedom we have today. This time I'm going to have y'all ring Collins to come up and give the invocation.
Let's bow our heads in prayer. Heavenly Father, we gather here today with grateful hearts, remembering the brave men and women who have made the ultimate sacrifice for our freedom. As we honor their memory on this Memorial Day, we ask for your presence and guidance. Lord, we thank you for the courage and selflessness for those who laid down their lives in service for our nation. We are humbled by their sacrifice and the sacrifices of their family. May their legacy inspire us to live with purpose and to cherish the freedoms we enjoy. We ask for your comfort and peace to be upon the families who have lost loved ones. Surround them with your love and strengthen them in their times of grief. May they find solace in the knowledge that they know their loved one's sacrifice was not in vain, and they are honored and remembered. Lord, we also pray for the men and women who are currently serving in our armed forces. Protect them, give them courage, and bring them home safely to their families. Bless the leaders with whom are leading our nation, Lord God. We just ask that you give them discernment and make the decisions for our nation to continue to live in freedom, Lord. And in this time of remembrance, we ask that we come together in unity and gratitude, and let us never forget the cost of our freedom that was given by these folks who laid down their lives, and help us honor them by remembering their sacrifice. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you, Yalring. This time the color guard, is the color guard ready? The color guard will do their thing and then the national anthem and taps. Thank you. Let's give a big hand to the Nelsonville York Band. I'd like to thank the Color Guard from the VFW for all their help and what they did this morning. But this time, I'm going to have Greg Jolly come up, and he's going to sing a song. I don't know what it is, but he does, I hope.
Like I only got a one-way ticket over here. Sure wish I could give you one more kiss. And war was just a game we played when we were kids. I'm laying down my gun, I'm hanging up my boots. I'm up here with God and we're both watching over you. So lay me down in that open field out on the edge of town. And know my soul is where my mom always prayed that it would go. If you're reading this, I'm already home. If you're reading this, halfway around the world, I won't be there to see the birth of our little girl. Sure wish she loved like you. Hope she finds like me and the weed. I'm laying down my gun, I'm hanging up my boots. Tell Dad I don't regret that I followed in his shoes. So lay me down in that open field out on the edge of town. Oh, my soul is where my mom always prayed that it would go. And if you're reading this, I'm already home. If you're reading this, there's gonna come a day when you'll move on and find someone else, and that's okay. Just remember this, I'm in a better place, where soldiers live in peace and angels sing amazing grace. So lay me that open field out on the edge of town. And oh, my soul is where my mom always prayed that it would go. If you're reading this, if you're reading this, I'm already home.
Greg really does a good job. I love to listen to him. At this time, we're going to have our speaker come up. He's a retired Air Force First Sergeant, 20 years, Yaring Collins. Would you please come up and let him do a little talking? He promised me he would keep it under an hour, so don't get too impatient.
Don't worry. When I first wrote this speech, the speech was like 2 minutes long, and my wife told me you might want to do it a little bit longer. So I'll keep it under 10 minutes, though, I promise. All right, so Memorial Day is a time to honor and remember those who have given their lives in military service to our country. It's a day to reflect on the sacrifices of these brave men and women and to express gratitude for their service. By remembering their sacrifice, we honor their memory and recognize the importance of their contributions to our nation's freedom and security. Memorial Day serves as a reminder for the high cost of freedom and the debt of gratitude we owe to those who have laid down their lives for our country. John 15:13 says, "Greater love has none than this, than to lay down one's life for his friends." This very powerful phrase captures the essence of Memorial Day by highlighting the ultimate act of love and sacrifice. Memorial Day is a time to honor and remember the men and women who have laid down their lives in service to this country. These brave individuals have made the greatest sacrifice by giving up their lives to protect and ensure the freedoms and safety of others, essentially laying down their lives for their friends, family, and fellow citizens. Jesus' words here in John 15:13 speak to this profound act of love by comparing the selfless act of dying for others to the greatest form of love. This verse also serves as a reminder of the broader implications of service and love, not only in the military, but in the context of our daily lives. Recognizing and honoring those who have given their lives for our country is an essential duty. These individuals made the ultimate sacrifice, and acknowledging their service ensures that their actions are not forgotten. It is a way of paying tribute to their courage and selflessness. Honoring the fallen inspires a sense of patriotism and civic duty. When we reflect on their stories of those who have served and sacrificed, we are reminded of the values that underpin our nation: freedom, justice, and unity. One such hero, Ronald E. Rossner, was born on October 24, 1929. He grew up in Roseville, Ohio, where he experienced a modest upbringing in a working-class family. Rossner's sense of duty and patriotism were evident early on, and his first enlistment into the United States Army in 1946, serving until 1949. Rossner re-enlisted in 1951 after his younger brother, Richard, was killed in action during the Korean War. Driven by a sense of vengeance and a desire to honor his brother's memory, Rossner volunteered for combat duty in Korea. He was assigned to a heavy mortar company, the 38th Infantry Regiment, 2nd Infantry Division. And on January 12, 1952, near the town of Pingali in Korea, Rossner displayed extraordinary heroism during a critical engagement. Despite being outnumbered and under intense enemy fire, Rossner charged an enemy position multiple times. Armed with a carbine and grenades, he inflicted significant casualties on the enemy and allowed his unit to retreat and regroup. Even after sustaining injuries, he continued the assault and personally carried several wounded comrades to safety. His actions during this battle exemplified incredible bravery and self-sacrifice, earning him the Medal of Honor on June 27, 1952. Rossner is remembered not only for his valor on the battlefield, but also for his unwavering dedication to his fellow soldiers and his country. His story serves as an inspiration and reminder of the sacrifice made by those who have served in the armed forces. Rossner's bravery and dedication reflect the highest values of military service, and his actions remind us of the profound cost of freedom that we enjoy today. Rossner's story is not just one of heroism, but one of profound self-sacrifice. He, like many others, answered the call to serve, placing the well-being of others above their own. As we remember his gallantry, we are also called to remember all those who have fallen in service to our country. Each one of them has a story, a family, and a legacy that we must honor and never forget. As we gather in remembrance, let us also turn our hearts to God, thanking him for the courage and the sacrifice of the fallen heroes. Let us pray for their families and those who continue to serve in our armed forces. Their bravery also allows us to live in a nation where freedom and justice prevail. Memorial Day is a time for reflection, gratitude, and unity. It is a day to honor the memory of those who have given everything for the freedoms that we enjoy today. Let us commit ourselves to never forget their sacrifice and to live in a way that honors their legacy. May we also remember that just as our heroes paid the price for our freedom, Jesus paid the price for our ultimate eternal salvation. And thank you, and may God bless you, God bless our fallen heroes, and God bless the United States of America.
Man, I couldn't have said that better if I'd done it myself. All right, continuing on. The next thing we're going to be doing is giving the Hard Souls Award. Hard Souls is the one that took care of the village of Buchtel, kept the streets clean, and did everything for years and years. We've been giving this award out for a number of years. This year, we have a lady that has really worked her behind off taking care of the ballpark and all the park arrangements over there. This time I have to stop and think of her name. Nikki Klein, would you please step up? Congratulations.
Thank you.
Village of Buchtel proudly presents the Hard Souls Award to Nikki Klein.
Thank you.
She wants a picture.
Thanks, Rob. I hit you with my glass, sorry.
All right. I got Greg Jolly's going to come back and do one more song, and then we're going to be kind of wrapping things down. Greg? Before he gets started, if you'd like to make a donation to the veterans thing, I'd appreciate it. They really work hard and take care of things. So, thank you, George and Helen.
If tomorrow all things were gone, I worked for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. An American, where at least I know I'm free, and I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me, and I'd gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. Of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, from New York to LA, there's pride in every American heart, and it's time we stand and say, I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free, and I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me, and I'd gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free, I won't forget the man who died, who gave that right to me. And I'd gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. This time I'd like to thank a few people. If anybody noticed the eagle on the tree stump, that was donated by Dale, the chainsaw carver that comes into Buchtel. He carved that for us and donated it. We had to take that tree down because it was just rotten and a lot of bad limbs on it. Also, I'd like to thank George and Helen for putting up the pictures up here. I know they worked hard on it and helped Patty, who was a little under the weather and couldn't do anything. I'd like to thank Andy for the PA system from the church over town. He always comes over and helps us out. Also, Rodney on the work of the new museum building. Like to make, I know this is for veterans that passed away and gave their life so that we might be free. But I do notice a sign out here. Buchtel has the oldest living veteran, John L. Sullivan, right over here. I'd invite you to tour the mine museum over there. I know Rodney's really worked hard on it. And ice cream and flags, band, be sure and get up there and get your ice cream and flags. I'd like to thank the band again. I'd like to thank Greg Jolly for his beautiful songs. This time I'm going to have the benediction by Pastor Yareen.
Let's bow our heads. Lord, I just pray that you just continue to watch over us, continue to protect us, and continue to be there for us, Lord God, pouring out your grace and mercy across this nation. Again, we just thank you for all the people who serve, Lord God, in the past, currently, and in the future, Heavenly Father. We just ask that you just continue to raise up brave men and women to continue to serve this country and give us the freedoms that we love and we cherish. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
That concludes today's celebration. I appreciate everybody that come out. I know I was really worried yesterday when the rain was coming down, but the good Lord blessed us. Thanks again for coming out. Have a great day.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for being here to observe this Memorial Day service. I'm the commander of the American Legion Post in Glouster. I'm an Army veteran. At this moment now, we will have our morning prayer by Pastor John Haining.
Let us pray. Gracious and loving Heavenly Father, we stand before you this day remembering the sacrifice of your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, for all. And we accept his gift of salvation. We thank you this Memorial Day for the many veterans, for the brave men and women who loved this nation so much that they made the ultimate sacrifice for us, giving their very lives for the freedom that we also enjoy. We thank you for seeing fit to give us this great nation, which was made and founded so we could worship and honor you for those who have given their all so we could. We pray that you'll touch each one gathered here this day in a very special way. Encourage us not to take for granted the sacrifices made by the veterans we honor this day. Be with the families whose loved ones who have made the ultimate sacrifice for us as well. Never let us take any of them for granted. We as a nation have rejected you in many ways, turning our backs on your standards and your morality. Forgive us, O Lord, for rejecting you and bringing shame on those who gave their all to protect our freedom. When we cry, God bless America, may we be sincere. May you restore us to being a great nation we were founded to be. We ask also you continue to bless those brave men and women who are sacrificing yet today and in the future to maintain our freedom. We ask this in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, John. At this time, the Boy Scouts will raise the flag. Today our speaker is a young man in my eyes that I've known for a long time. He's my son. He's a graduate of Glouster. And he is a very, very good speaker, better than I will ever be. And I'm proud to announce and introduce him, Scott Shamhart.
Thank you, Commander, Father. Good morning. Today, we honor the more than 1 million men and women who made the ultimate sacrifice for our nation while serving in wars and missions since the American Revolution. This date, May 30th, was chosen specifically because it was not on the anniversary of any known battle. It is the day to honor fallen veterans of all American wars. It was not originally called Memorial Day. It started out as Declaration Day at Arlington National Cemetery in 1868. The address was given by James A. Garfield, our former Ohio Congressman and 20th President of the United States. I would like to share some passages from his address that day. I am oppressed with a sense of the impropriety of uttering words on this occasion. If silence is ever golden, it must be here, beside the graves of 15,000 men whose lives are more significant than speech, and whose death was a poem, the music which can never be sung. With words we make promises, plight faith, praise virtue. Promises may not be kept, plighted faith may be broken, and vaunted virtue be only the cunning mask of vice. We do not know what promise these men made, one pledge they gave, one word they spoke, but we do know they summed up and perfected by one supreme act the highest virtues of men and citizens. For love of country, they accepted death and thus resolved all doubts and made immortal their patriotism and their virtue. For the noblest man that lives, there still remains a conflict. He must still withstand the assaults of time, and fortune must still be assailed with temptations before which lofty natures have fallen. But with these, the conflict ended, the victory was won, when death stamped on them the great seal of heroic character and closed a record which years can never blot. As Mr. Garfield stated, there are not enough or the right words to adequately convey what our fallen have given as sacrificed. The official birthplace of Memorial Day came from Waterloo, New York, and became commonly used instead of Declaration Day after World War II. The name of the day, though, is not the end result. It is have a day to remember and honor our fallen. Just as there have been many that have fallen, there are just as many stories about each and every one of them. Each story is unique, and each story represents heartbreak to the family and friends left to mourn. I share some of these stories with you here. Private Furman L. Smith, who served with the Army's 135th Infantry Regiment, 34th Infantry Division. 80 years ago, his unit came under intense fire from German forces in Italy. Severely outnumbered by the enemy, Private Smith tended to seriously wounded comrades and emptied clip after clip of his M1 Garand rifle and killed at least 10 enemy soldiers before he was fatally shot. The 19-year-old was posthumously awarded the Medal of Honor. Lieutenant Colonel Annie Ruth Graham, who served in the Army Nurse Corps during World War II, the Korean War, and in Vietnam. It was while she was assigned to the 91st Evacuation Hospital in Tuy Hoa that she succumbed to a stroke in 1968. She's one of eight women whose names are on the Vietnam Veterans Memorial in Washington, D.C. Colonel William Rich Higgins was a Marine who served as a chief observer on a United Nations peacekeeping mission in 1988 when he was driving on a coastal road in southern Lebanon when his car was suddenly blocked by another vehicle and was taken hostage by terrorists. He endured months of torture before his capture released a video of his hanging. He was declared dead by the U.S. government in 1990. He was survived by his wife and his daughter. Navy SEALs Nathan Gage Ingram and Christopher J. Chambers attempted to board an unflagged ship in the Arabian Sea that was carrying weapons on their way to Yemen on January 11th. As they were attempting to climb aboard the contraband ship to seize the illegal arms, the seaways enveloped them, plunging them to the depths, but they were never seen again. So many missions, conflicts, wars, each man and woman who perished were performing their unique duties that were asked of them, just like these stories told today. They served our country and protected all of us from enemies and terror that was sometimes readily present, but sometimes often hidden. Hidden to us and unbeknown to us. And they paid that price to protect their country, their families, their friends. Over 1 million of them now. Many from our own communities, Glouster, Trimble, Jacksonville, surrounding communities. They too have their own unique stories. And generations of their families and friends who will always remember their courage, their bravery, and their sacrifice, their ultimate sacrifice. As proud Americans, we should remember that our freedom is not free. Our living veterans know this all too well. They know what it took, what it still takes for this freedom to persevere. They performed heroism and witnessed it watching their brothers and sisters fall. It is only possible because these heroes, some from our own families, towns, and neighborhoods, have paid a high price. It's a price which enables us to have ceremonies and observances like this in towns across this great country. We're able to raise families, continue careers, and live good lives because of the young men and women who never came home. We must always remember them. May they rest in peace. It has been an honor and a privilege to be with you here today. Thank you for coming. God bless you and God bless America.
Thank you, Scott. It's a good message. At this time, we'll have another selection from the Trimble High School Band. Thank you.
Thank you, Reuben. Nice job, band. This time, we'll have our closing prayer by Pastor John Hain. And after that, I will read the names on our monument before we salute the dead.
Let us pray. Gracious and loving Heavenly Father, once again we are thankful for the veterans that have sacrificed their all, given their all for each and every one of us, a sacrifice of love, a selfless sacrifice for our nation, for our freedom, and for all the freedoms we so enjoy. We thank you for each of the veterans that are gathered here this day. Pray you'll surround them as well and encourage them as they strive to continue to honor our nation and to honor you. We've this day been blessed by the band, also here to honor you. So we pray that each one here will have a safe day of travel, encouragement and blessing. But most importantly, we want to honor those fallen veterans, those who gave their all for us, and seek your blessing upon their families. We ask all this in Jesus' holy name. Amen.
Thank you, John. World War I, 1917 to 1918. James Cox, Frank McCann, Roy Sampson. World War II, 1941 to 1945. Virgil Brooks, Robert Brown, Ernest Burgess, Paul Byers, Cloyd Clemens, Andrew E. Cavella, Joseph Dalton, Lawrence Frederick, Dylan Gill, Ernest Hawkins, Charles W. Herbert, Joseph Hooper, Louis Jenness, Robert S. Jones, Torino Camento, Herman H. Clough, Clyde L. Lowry, Donald Mascola, Ernest Meeks, Elmer Miller, William Moody, Byron J. Morse, Robert Poole, Darrell F. Roberts, Leroy E. Roberts, Foster Skinner, Stanley Skinner, George Smith, Virgil Strohmeyer Jr., Harold Bohr, John Williams, Charles W. Witham, William F. Witham. Korean War, 1950 to 1955. Robert A. Blackford, Claremont L. Gibbs, Ira N. Newman, Kenneth L. Skinner, Stephen Thomas. Vietnam War, 1964 to 1975. Donald A. Campbell, Larry E. Herbert, William E. McLean, Thomas A. Sayers. Master Sergeant Chrisman, salute our dead. Present arms. playing taps today was Ethan Skinner and Lyota Seymour. That concludes our service today, and we thank everybody for coming. Please have a safe Memorial Day. Thank you.
Country loved and mercy more than life. Yeah. America, sweet America. Ooh. May God thy gold refine. Yes, sir. Till all success. Shall it be nobleness? Oh, yeah. And every gain divine. You know, when I was in school, well, we said it like this. Oh, beautiful. For spacious skies. War amber waves of grain. Look out, look out. For purple mountain majesties. Grace on thee, you ought to love him today.
sea to shine, shining sea. Oh, you ought to sing that with me if you can.